So the question now is, can we transmit more information on the same carrier? So can we? Transmit more info on the same carrier. So essentially, maybe two bits at the same time and not just one. And the answer to this is yes, we can. And the idea behind this is to transmit more information is that cosine and sine are orthogonal. Yeah, so this means a cosine and a sine wave won't interfere each other with each other. So what means orthogonal in these terms? Orthogonal means that if I'm doing integral over cosine multiplied by sine of t, that this becomes zero. And so now remember what we do in our transmitter and receiver. Yeah, so remember phase modulation. Uses multiplication of cosine waves. So then obviously because of this idea, then if we're transmitting also sine waves, then they should not interfere with the cosine waves. So this leads us to the idea of quadrature modulation. And having the phase modulation idea behind us, it's very, very simple now. So imagine we have a stream S of t again, and we multiply that with our carrier. So let's write this here properly out like cosine of 2 pi ft. So we have a cosine wave. And then what we can do at the same time, we can create a phase shift of 90 degrees and create a sine wave 2 pi ft. And this sine wave we can multiply with another simple stream here. So let's call this here SR and this one here SI of t. So we can, and now the interesting thing is because these two output waves have a 90 degree phase shift, we can just add them together. Yeah, so just a summation unit, and we transmit these ones. So instead of just using a cosine wave and transmitting that, we're also using a sine wave and transmitting that. And then on the receiving side, so if we call this the quadrature demodulation, we do just the opposite. So we are receiving this mixed signal here. Okay, let's bring back this other one here quickly and call this here just y of t. And then after it's sent over through our channel here, we are receiving this signal here. And so what we do is we split this up, and again we multiply this. And remember, because of our orthogonal properties of cosine and sine, so if we do a cosine of 2 pi ft and we're doing a sine of 2 pi ft here and multiply this, they won't interfere with each other, and so we can extract via the low pass filter our SR of t here, and via our low pass filter here our SI of t here, completely independently. And then we've got obviously again a threshold here. Then we just need to combine this data, and we're getting our bitstream back out there again. So simple as that.